Welcome to Faith and Barbells Podcast. I am Brian Knight, your host. I'm going to start in John 14 today. Verse 15. If you love me, keep my commandments. I will pray the Father, and he shall send you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, who the world cannot receive, because it sees him not, neither knoweth him not. But you know him. That's our focus today. But you know him. How do you know him? And the real question is, do you know God? It says, you know him, for he dwells with you and shall be in you. And I will not leave you alone. I won't leave you comfortless or orphans. I will come to you. Yet a little while, and the world sees me no more, but you see me, because I live, you shall live also. In that day you shall know that I am in the Father, and he in you and me, and that I in you. And he that keeps my commandments and keepeth them, he knows my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him and will manifest myself to him. That's huge. Verse 27, the peace I leave with you, my peace, and I give unto you, not as the world gives, but give I unto you. And let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. You have heard how I said unto you, I go away and come again unto you. If you loved me, you would rejoice, because I said, I go to the Father, for my Father is greater than I. And now I have told you before it comes to pass, that it has come to pass. When it comes to pass, you might believe. Hereafter I will not talk much with you, for the prince of this world comes and has nothing in me. But that the world may know that I love the Father, and the Father gave me commandment, even as I do, arise, let us go. Knowing God. That today's topic today, knowing God. And the real concept here is, do you know God? And if you do, how do you know him? You know, knowing someone is a vital thing for a relationship, clearly. You can't have a relationship with someone where you don't even know them. And I mean, like, know them, you know. You can have a, you know, you can know, I definitely know this, that, when I met my wife, I didn't know her. I didn't know what she was like, or I didn't know who our friends were, what she, her interests were. I just knew that, you know, she was a beautiful woman, that I had to get to know her. What I had to do was spend time with her. Right? See, a lot of people, when it comes to God, when it comes to the Lord, Jesus, Father, they don't actually know God. They don't know what he's like. And that's not good. Right? That's not helpful in understanding who he is at all. They don't actually know his characteristics. They know about him. They know that he created the world. You know, they know that, you know, he brought the flood and he killed lots of people in the Old Testament, that he sent his son Jesus. And that's awesome. Praise God he did. Thank you that he sent Yeshua, the Messiah, the Savior of all, right? That he shed his blood. Excuse me. But he did not, a lot of people don't really know him. You know, like a man knows his wife and has a kid. You know, it says that Adam knew Eve and Cain was born, right? Cain and Abel were born. And then Seth and then others. But Adam and Eve knew each other on an intimate level that's private. And there are things that we can do and know who God is on that intimate and private level. I mean, first of all, just knowing about him is one thing. I mean, Satan knows about him, right? I know he doesn't love God. I mean, there's no love in the enemy. But he knows about him. And many, many people who go to church who claim to be religious or Christian, so-called Christian, or say they love God, they only know about him. And they don't truly know him. And that is the gist of it all. In this episode, I really just want you to think and look inside yourself. Look inside yourself and question yourself and say, you know what? Do I know who God is, or do I just know about him? Do I know how he handles situations? Do I know what his true nature is? And a lot of people don't. The true nature of God is loving and goodness and mercy. Micah 6:8 is one of the best scriptures. It's one of my favorites. It says, O man of God, O thou man of God, how should thou live? What should thou do, right? It says that you should do justly, you should love mercy, and walk humbly before your God. And that's what God, he does justly. He is merciful. And that's his characteristic. Merciful. The flood in the Old Testament, right, of Noah, it was mercy to save mankind. Not to just... Most people look at it as doom and gloom, and that he destroyed all men and all living beasts of the field and so on. And yeah, that happened. But he did that to save the remnant of people who were pure, to bring about the Messiah, to bring about the one who could redeem us and did redeem us. So that is truly... truly the heart of God. He's good and he's loving, and he loves you. Not because you go to church 15 times a month, or not because you've read your Bible all week, right? That is not why. He is not a God that loves you because you've done something. He's not a God that loves you because of your performance. You know, my pastor, Daniel Villarreal, at Grace Avenue Church in San Antonio, Texas, he said that this week, which was powerful. I'm just stealing that line. He is not a God of performance. That he doesn't love you because of your performance. He loves you because he created you, and he is a loving God. Right? Peter wrote in the New Testament that God is not willing that anyone should perish. I mean, after all, he sent his only son, his only begotten son, John 3, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And if that's not a good God, I don't know what is. There is nothing other than that, good. A God who takes and sees a sinful nature of people. People whose heart is evil. And don't say your heart's not evil before you were born again. Because you are selfish, and we are selfish a lot of times, most of the time now. right? An unbelieving heart. The Bible says it's an evil heart. Someone who's negative and full of fear and full of doubt and full of hate, rage, and that's the characteristics of the God of this world, Satan, the enemy, right? Fallen Lucifer. But he sent God, the Father in heaven, the Most High, sent Jesus. Pure Jesus. Uncorrupted, without spot. And Jesus accepted. Yes, I'm going to do that. I'm going to sacrifice myself so that my children, even though they've spit on me, they've cursed me, they've ignored me, man, that's good. That's good. So know him. How do you know him? You spend time with him, right? It's let's read it again. It says, if verse 17, John 14, 17, the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive because it sees him not, neither knows him, but you know me, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. Well, how does he dwell with you? Because they hung around and they were with Jesus. That's the only way you get to know somebody. You get around God. You get into your word. You get your Bible. If you don't have one, buy one. Download the app. But I suggest you buy one. Read at least a chapter a day. And you start listening. Get quiet. Be around God. Learn his word. That's who he is. This book isn't a book of hate. It's a book of love. A good goodness. That's why they call it the gospel. It's the good news. Because he's good. So know him. Right? Know him. Not just know about God. Know about the Savior. Know about the Holy Spirit. But find out who he is. And begin to cultivate that knowing. That relationship. Oh man. Friend. Life would change once you start that. Life changes. Peace begins to dwell in your life. Peace begins to surround you like never before. Oh, it's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing. I'm telling you, when you experience the understanding that God is good and that peace is a tangible way of life, and you develop a relationship with the Most High, with the Holy Spirit, when you get to know Jesus and you hear his voice, and the Bible says, and then a voice of a stranger, you will not follow because you know his voice and you know him like you know your wife, or like a wife knows a husband. Right? You know your hand. You know the cuts, the calluses, the shapes, the back of the hand, the front of the hand. Because you've taken time and you've looked at it. You've examined it. You maybe haven't measured it yet, but you felt it. You've manicured it. You know it. And I'm urging you today. Do that with God. Do that with the Lord Jesus. He's the one that we should know. And man, all kinds of things will change in your life. I encourage you today, do that. Let me pray for you. Father in heaven, we love you. In Jesus' name, Lord, we come to you and we just thank you. We thank you for that sacrifice that you've sent Jesus for. We thank you for the sacrifice that you've given us a way through him to you. Father, thank you for changing us and keep revealing to us, Lord. I pray you continue to reveal to me and to the audience here all around the globe. And thank you for continuing to manifest yourself to us as we dig into you, to know you. It's such a wonderful thing to know you. Oh, thank you, Lord, for the opening the eyes and the hearts of the people listening. In Jesus' name, we praise you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Amen. Amen. Man, knowing God is good. You got to know a barbell too to lift one. It's the same concept, you know. No, today was a good day. 6 a.m. Oh, we clean and jerked at CrossFit, and it's just amazing how when I work out, it's so many things in life that's kind of, you know, correlates with that. You know, you have to commit to get under that bar. The barbell is a trainer for life, man. Just like the Word of God, it trains me for life, and it trains you for life. The barbell is the same thing. You have to have courage. You have to have faith that you're going to pick that up. You're going to bump it off your body correctly. You're going to tuck under it and stand up. I mean, if you fear that barbell, it's going to ruin and wreck your every time. Yeah, today was clean and jerk max. I just went to 285. Pretty good, solid rep. Cut that out. And then we did a long EMOM of work. Every minute on the minute, we did something different. We farmer's carry for 1 minute, box jumps, and then we did overhead carry. And a bunch of other stuff. It was good. I had a good time. I like those long workouts sometimes. Just kind of clean you out. You know, 30 minutes of just hard work with a little rest here and there. Just keep moving. Keep studying. It's a good day when you get a bunch of work at the gym in. All right. You guys be blessed. All right. Catch you next time. Thanks a lot for listening. I'm Brian Neitch, and this is Faith and Barbells, and we love faith, we love the Word of God, and ain't nothing wrong with picking up a barbell.